a theme that comes back, and it's sort of, it tends to come back more often through the record, is like the teenage angst, high school love stories, you know, just being young and, you know, whatever, being, you know, rambunctious, being, you know, an anarchist, being in love, like all the silly little things that you deal with in high school. Definitely, I mean, that was sort of one of the ideas with the record, was we wanted to touch base a lot on that, so we can, you know, maybe there are some younger audiences that can relate to it, and then even some of the older audiences can, like, reflect back and get that, like, oh, yeah, I remember, you know, this reminds me of that time. And now that Impossible is finally out and in stores and online, and people are talking about it, people are liking it, people are hating it, people are excited about it, I'm so happy that it's finally made its way to the musical circle that is, you know, Canada and America. The band's ecstatic. We're so stoked. It feels like this big, like, brick has been taken off my shoulders. Just got back from a month-long tour with Face to Face, Strung Out, and it's a band called Darlings. And on that tour, we were doing 8 songs, and 6 of which were off Impossible, and 2 of which are from our EP, Let's Start a Ride. We thought it would be a good chance to keep some of the old EP songs to give that, you know, give people a taste of that, as well as the brand new record. Sell 2 records instead of 1. This tour was crazy because we weren't playing to any really like 20 and unders. It was really a lot of like old school, you know, like punk rock dudes from the, you know, mid to early 90s. It was Face to Face 20 year anniversary, so there's a lot of guys that are there that like now have kids and like took a night off from the wife. But I'll never forget when we played in Minneapolis, Minnesota, which is one of my like dream cities to play. I played there 10 years ago, and to go back and play the same venue we played First Ave, where, you know, the Replacements, Soul Asylum, like, you name it, like, all the bands, all the Minneapolis bands got their start there. We played there, and it was sold out, so there was about 600, 700 people there. And I remember as soon as we were done, our last chord, we struck, like, thanks for the artist life, from Canada, you guys have been awesome, you know, Darlings are up next, or whatever. We heard from, like, the balcony, best opening band ever, and it wasn't sarcastic. It was actually like they were genuinely excited to see us.